Führerschein ist.
So right now I'm headed north, kind of north-northwest. The town of Snohomish is behind me. The little town of Machias is up ahead. As you can see, this trail is nice and wide, relatively newly paved. They've been doing some work out here. The intersection up here, what they call the Machias Cutoff. Looks like they're going to be putting in a light for the foot and bike and horse traffic. Yes, there are horses that are allowed on this trail, along with the bikes and the pedestrians and joggers. So anyway, go for a little bike ride. This trail follows an old railroad grade, so it's relatively level. There's a little bit of up and down, little dips and little hills to climb and stuff like that, but nothing steep, nothing long. I've done this before, a couple years back. The trail actually goes for, I think it's like 37 miles or something like that, from the town of Snohomish all the way up to Arlington. There you can head east towards Darrington on a different trail, or you can keep heading north. I think all the way to Mount Vernon is as far as they've gone with it. Anyway, nice day for a ride. It's 58 degrees out, a little bit of a breeze, not too bad. Traffic, as you can see on the road to my left, not much different than a regular Monday before the quarantine, or not quarantine, but the stay-at-home order. But getting out and exercising is still allowed, as long as you don't congregate in groups of 25 or more. You can see the little path on the right here, that's for the horses. See here in a second, coming up on the right, Mount Pilchuck and Three Finger and White Horse. They are still snow covered towards the top. The weather's been cold the last few weeks, cold and rainy. This is the second and third dry day we've had. It's actually pretty warm for this time of year. As you can see, a fair amount of traffic on this trail. But that's good. It keeps people from going wacko. So up in the distance, you should be able to see the one dead ahead. Mountain they call Three Finger. The one on the right, which I'll give you a view of it here in a second. The one on the right is Mount Pilchuck. So we're coming for the first major intersection here. Surprisingly, there's no traffic. I'm not sure how far I'll go today. This is my first outing in about a year, I think. So I want to be able to make it back. That said, 4.5 miles. That would be from the town of Snohomish. I did not start there. I started about halfway. This up here on the right is one of the parking areas for the Centennial Trail. It's currently closed. They're all closed right now. So everyone is having to find parking on the street. That's why I parked at the school. During the summer, this little place on the right here, little blue one, they sell ice cream and drinks. Crossing a bridge that goes over one of the many streams that crisscross the valley. They all empty into the Pilchuck River, which is over here to my right, about half a mile. But every so often, well, anytime you find a stream, there's going to be a bridge. So I am coming up to the overpass for highway, I believe it's 97. It takes you from town of Lake Stevens, headed east into the mountains to the town of Granite Falls. You can tell I find a little bit of civilization because my phone just got a signal, a cell signal, and told me that I have an email. But it can wait. The nice thing is that every once in a while you find where you a little hill that lets you coast. Always a plus. So here's another one of these out of the way intersections where you gotta look for traffic. Somebody's driveway. As I said earlier, there's a few of these along the way. Some have stop signs, some don't. Coming up on Lake Cassidy, it is just north of Lake Stevens. What I am noticing is that the skunk cabbage is blooming. It because boy, does it stink out here. Not only can you smell it, but you can taste it. It is nasty. Ooh, baby, that's bad. Okay, I have made it to Lake Cassidy Wayside. It's over here on the left. In the summer, this place is packed. Is the dock open or will I get arrested? Yeah, I guess so. So we'll take a little jaunt down on the dock here. Gonna be a little bumpy. Never really done too good on it, except for crappie fishing. The crappie in here, they don't grow big, but they are numerous. I think there you can see the guy in the kayak. Right there. Little paddle one. So the lake is not very big. You can see this is the very south end of it over here. I lost about a 6-pound bass over on that shoreline over there years ago. The road to the lake goes over there. The boat ramp is over there. It's a state boat ramp. A lot of guys that live here on the lake, they'll bring their Christmas trees out here, tie them down with rock and brick we used to use back in the 60s and 70s for making shelves in the dorms. They'll tie them down with those and then sink them, and that becomes structure for the fish. If you know where those are at, and if you're having me one right out there, the crappie fishing can be really good. Anyway, this is the lake. Like I said, it's not very big. It's shaped, the bottom is shaped kind of like a bowl. Over there, by the boat ramp over there, years back there was a huge, huge bald eagle that was nesting over there. I never saw her mate, but she was huge. She probably stood a good 3 feet high, man. She was enormous. You could see her from a long ways away sitting up in her perch up there waiting to find fish. So if you look in that tree straight ahead, you can see a nest. It's a little small to be an eagle, so it's probably an osprey. But up towards that first set of branches down from the top. So I don't know if you can see the sign, but this is the trail I am doing. Let's see if I can get the camera up close. If you can read that, the Centennial Trail. That's the one I'm on. Okay, so I've started my 7-mile trek back to the car. I think this way the trail grade is a little more sloped downhill, so it shouldn't be as hard on the legs. But it's still going to take me a while to get there because I'm tired. My legs are sore. I'm saddle sore. And I haven't eaten in about about 3 hours. So okay, so here's the skunk cabbage. I don't know if you can see how well you can see it there, but as I said, you can taste it in the air. It smells nasty, and it is in full bloom. Actually getting there anyway. It's all along the trail here towards Lake Cassidy, where it gets more swampy. The nice thing about going back is I have the downhill grade most of the way, so I can coast quite a bit. Not coasting fast, but I am coasting. So I am almost back to Machias, which means I'm probably about 3 miles from the car. And as I said, these miles are piling up quick because I'm able to have a fair amount of speed coasting down this railroad grade. So it's not too bad. Kind of reminds me of the little pedal riders that we rode out at Wallawa Lake a couple years back. Heading out was a workout. No, heading out was easy because it was downhill grade. Coming back was a workout. There you had two people pedaling, not one. So yeah, this coming back is kind of nice. So this is one of those creeks that I was mentioning earlier that bisect the trail every once in a while. Not exactly sure the name of it, but it's a pretty little creek. Here you can see the water, and it comes around the corner there. The salmon actually run up this creek when they're spawning in the fall. So it's 5:15 right now, and I've noticed as the sun is headed further down in the west, I'm riding more in the shadows, and it's gotten a little bit cooler because my fingers are a little cold right now. But I'm almost back to the car, so I'm not going to bother to change out my gloves from my fingerless to my regular gloves. Yeah, now that I'm on the far side of the hill, out in the sun, it's warmed up quite a bit. I can feel my fingers warming up. Turn the bike around again. And give you another view of the mountains here. Mount Pilchuck, Three Fingers, White Horse off far left, and over on this side, I don't know if you can hear him. I'll bring him around here in a minute.
Hi.
Hi. You can see across the street over in the red barn. You can hear them, the goats. There's some chickens there. See him, you can see him up on top of the little stoop, whatever that is there. Anyway, life out in the boonies. It's never boring. Give you another view of the mountains there. This is the way home. So I've made it back to the school where my car is parked. It's still there. Nobody made off with it. Wasn't towed away. It's about 14 mile round trip. I'm going to get off my bike, hit the button, and call it a day.
Wait to cross South Machias Road at Centennial Trail. Wait.
Centennial Middle School, the Grandpa Mobile. I want to say thanks for joining me on my ride, and I hope you're having a good time during this stay at home time at home.